Patty first approached me with the idea of doing a gospel record, or a record of spiritual songs, one of the first things she said was that I'd love to have a room to sing in where I can feel my voice.
And I said, let's do it in a church. And I was thinking, you know, some little country church somewhere.
And I'd just recently been in Downtown Presbyterian Church here. And the minute I walked in, there was just a feeling about it.
He told me, I found the church. And I just had no idea what he was talking about. I thought, you know, a little country church somewhere. He said, yeah, it's in downtown Nashville. And I thought, what's that all about? When it spoke, my soul caught on fire. What it is just this beautiful 150-plus-year-old church with lovely, lovely architectural pieces and high ceilings and a lot of soul. It was a Civil War hospital with about 250 beds. That and all the people moving through here, being baptized here and having funerals here for 150 years in this building, I mean, it's filled with soul.
It would just feel right to be playing these songs in a beautiful old church, because a lot of the songs are real old, and have that sound of a church on the record. I am
Well, I sort of have this like very eclectic spirituality going on myself. I grew up Catholic, I've studied Buddhism, I've been reading the poems of Rumi for the last couple of years. And I think the thing that has been so valuable to me about making this record was, first of all, I had to challenge some prejudices that I had from my Catholic upbringing that I brought with me towards like just Christian terminology. It's just as bad to be, just hear a word that you associate with something negative and just go, oh, and just shut the door on that. And so these songs are built around those words, some of those words that I was afraid to use for a long time, just from certain questions that I had about my Catholic upbringing. Most of the material was chosen through Buddy Miller. I asked him to just educate me on the genre, and he went all over the map and sent a lot of things my way, including some Bob Dylan music and when he did his gospel music. And that actually just inspired me to write a couple of things of my own for this record.
We're both big, big fans of old gospel staple singers. Rain in the water, God's
gonna trouble water. I just love the music, particularly black gospel music.
That kind of resonates deep with me, and I just kind of got excited just knowing she was interested in it, and I think I put together way too many songs, but just ones that I thought would be great to listen to on a drive, just to see which ones would strike a chord with her, and a bunch of them did.
All creatures of our God and King, lift up your voice and with us sing. Alleluia, alleluia.
One of the things that was really difficult for me to do was to find a hymn. I, you know, again, facing my prejudices and the terminology, you know, there's been so much conservatism around religion all over the world. And in this country, it's been around Christianity. And so some of that terminology was just, you know, I just never really, it was up, you know, am I going to be able to do this honestly?
Hallelujah.
He found this hymn, All Creatures of Our God and King, and it was taken from a text of St. Francis. The melody was written to evoke reverence, you know, for the wonder and the mystery. And I guess all of this stuff really is, you know, it's reaching for, you know, some kind of discussion of the mystery. But that song in particular, I really was afraid of. And I discovered that it's all beautiful. I mean, even a very, very traditional Christian melody sung in many different English-speaking Christian churches all over the world was something that I found beautiful, and that was this really eye-opening, wonderful lovely thing to discover. I was really moved singing the song. Michael Ramos is a really good friend of mine, and I asked him to find me a Spanish song. I needed to sort of pull my Catholicism in, and I think the Catholic songs are so much more beautiful in Spanish. They just are.
I remembered a song that I would hear in church back in Texas whenever I was a little bitty kid. So I came over to her house one day with a Mexican-Spanish hymnal.
He taught me the Spanish song about the Virgin of Guadalupe. And I do love that story and of her, and it was just really, really fun to do. And I don't plan again to do no he's that bad. To sing these songs, they're so strong and powerful, and they are spiritual. They're just, they have the spirit, and to do them well, you have to have that something going on here. And I had to really do what it took to get to that place. It was just amazing to be able to sing in a place that's just aesthetically this beautiful, but also, you know, you can feel it when you walk in here. I found the power. The soul caught on fire. He stopped by. That's my soul. He stopped by.